Now let's discover the page brand culture. This is element of language that you can use when you present your company, when you present yourself. And this is important for all your team, get the same language and get the same way to define your company. Like that, it creates a brand culture. Even if you are working alone, you need to structure your thought and your way you present yourself and your company. Let's discover manifesto. Manifesto, it's an additional page from your brand culture, because it's where you define who are you or who is your company, and some rules that make you this is también. We create work that is purposeful and meaningful. We continuously strive to improve our work. We use our work to achieve cultural norms and value. We treat others with kindness and respect. And the fact to just write this, it's important that you and everybody in the company understand what is también, what is your studio, what is you, even if you are alone, what is you, what defines you, because you attract who you are. And we will see in the chapter Find Your Niche that you need to attract people that fit with you and have the same value. So with this manifesto, it's also a good work to try to identify yourself or give an identity to your company. This is really important. And here you can find also the same red flag that we saw in the previous chapter. It can help also to see, okay, which kind of person we don't want to work at the studio, or if you're a freelancer, with which kind of person I don't want to work. Alone or not, it's important to have value and to respect it. Now let's discover the page engagement. It's not something essential, but for me it is, so I just wanted to share you this. But for every website, I like to have a carbon compensation of this website. For example, let's say I have a client called Webflow, and with website carbon calculator, I can see the carbon emission of this website during a year. As you can see, it is really not good. This web page emits the amount of carbon that 9 trees absorb in a year. So I'm going back to my Notion and I want to plant 9 trees. So if I'm going to one website called onetreeplanted.com, I can see the cost of planting tree. So here I type my number and that's it. And also you can have a certificate, so it's something cool to value when you finish a project or when you contact a new client. It's a positive thing that can be shared to everyone. Or you can also invest a percentage of the project to one good project. For example, there is a One Time for the Planet. I mean, it's more for French people, but it's a company that invest in the positive impact companies. So it's always good to be part of the change and to have a positive impact. This is the page Learn. It's a pretty easy database where I can find all the thing I want to watch, the course I want to watch, and to improve myself, my skills. And also it's a good way to have a database where all your team member can improve themselves by watching this course. Now we have now let's see the tools page. So this is a database, same as you can see. It's the same database that you can find on the new member onboarding. So I just went to reach the database called tool list, and as you can see, up I have the list of all the tools. So let me delete this and come back to my database of tools. So this is my database of tools, all the things I need to install. Like that, if one day my computer die, I don't care, because I have the list of all the things I need to install again. And this is pretty useful. It already happened to me, and I just need to check everything and install everything. So it's good to plan this in case that something happened. And also you can use in your new member onboarding like that, everybody is the line about the tech that you use at your studio. And the last page is curation. This is really important because if you want to get better, you need to shape your highs every day. Every day, you need to watch what's the best and analyze. So for that, every day I'm spending 10 minutes of my time, generally when I start to work, by checking the best websites in terms of web design, in terms of web of development, in terms of branding, to shape my highs and see what's the also the trends now, and also discover studio or agencies or freelancer that work really well, and also I can maybe add them in my list of my freelance database. And let me explain you every website that I have here, because I think it's a good mix of web design, development, branding. So the first one is Maxi Best Of. It's a great selection of website, of creative website, and every day you have like 3 or 4 new website. So you really can shape your eyes and discover new website every day. It's a good complement with, let me add it here, awards. For me, awards is like the best of the best. See, this is where you can find the best studio, the best freelancer. So every day I'm checking the site of the day to see, okay, how they did, how they did that, how I analyze the layout, which technologies they use. You analyze everything like that, you can discover and you can also improve yourself. Okay, which font they use, the color matching, everything. You need to analyze everything to understand and get better. Here you have another website called Kickenthick. I think my pronunciation is not good, but this is a selection of website, pretty brutalist, let's say, but it's really a high-end selection. You don't have a lot of updates. I mean, I think it's one per day or one every 2 days, but the selection is really good. As you can see, the style is really brutalist, but it's really interesting also. It's something really different from Maxi Best Of, for example. So I like to have a different also style and point of view. Here you can find Godly. What I like from Godly is that everything is in video. So you have directly a preview of animation and you really can discover a lot of things and a lot of animation. And this is really a great, great selection of website. So I really recommend Godly to check every day. It's like awards, Godly for me is the best, and Maxi Best Of after. Now another one is the responsive. The cool thing of the responsive, it's focus on the responsive. It show you the version on desktop and on mobile. So that's a cool way also to understand how designer transform the design when they jump into the mobile version. So I really like this website too. Plus it's really elegant. The brand identity. This is the best website about brand identity. You really can find a high selection of projects about branding, and this is a good way to discover a brand studio and a brand freelancer. Then the other is This Is Gray. This Is Gray is the account of I don't know who, because it's called This Is Gray, that every day is posting a talent that he discovered. For example, today you can see Albert Tercero. He can be a brand designer, or he can be an illustrator, or even a web designer. He just highlights someone in the community, and this is also a really good way to discover talent. This is overstate.es, and this is a crazy selection of websites. It's really different of what you can find on OWASP. It's really brutalist, experimental, but it's a good way to shake your ideas and also discover something out of the box. So I really like to go on other states to discover crazy stuff. As you can see, this website is really different what you can see on Hogwarts. Another, it's more design. It's an Instagram account that share beautiful project around branding, packaging. So it's a good way also to shape your eyes, discover color matching, font pairing, the importance of photography also. So every day I'm going there too. The other is Type01. So it's a good way to see and discover which font can be paired with others. And same, there is a mix of experimental things and more mainstream things. So I like to go there also. It's really interesting. For example, if you can see this, it can give you a lot of idea for a website page, for example, or this kind of thing, or this. There is a lot of great content, so go to jump there. Low, it's a website selection of website with a low carbon emission to show what we can do when we create a low energy website. So this is a good alternative also to discover what we can do, because sometimes clients have this goal to create a low emission website. So it's important to know and to see that it's possible to also do creative things even when you don't use 3D and all these crazy animations. Visual.co, it's also a great selection of branding project, and yeah, well curated. So I like to go there also every day. For example, this website is really, and this project is really good by Mouthwash. I highly recommend. And the last one is Visual Journal IT. It's a high selection of branding project, packaging project, and yeah, it's really amazing to discover all this beautiful talent and help you to push your own boundaries and to be more and more creative. I think it's really important. Curiosity make you get out of your comfort area and also to make you progress. So this is important to shape your eyes every single day. It's a must. It's like that you will get better also.